Now that, of course, that does mean SSB is probably not going to be able to go Marv in that one. He's going to default over the Rosalina. I got to see, his Marv just has looked so much better. He looked way more comfortable. It lets them... And his play style. The thing is, SSB will still play this front line, I'm going to go in style, but that's not what you want to do with Rosalina, I feel like.
No, you want... if anything, you want to basically do that with Luma yourself, and then basically... keep people away, and as soon as they get close, hit them with something, basically space it away. So, the other thing I'm almost interested to see if he actually does is, will he go Olimar if he doesn't want to go Marth or Rosalina? That is another big thing. So grand finals will be Knight Money and SSB 100 versus myself and Samfish.
Yep, and they just saw this matchup in Winners Final, if you guys were here for that one. SSB pivoting over to the Rosalina, and myself going with Ness, and Samfish going for his pretty much classic villager. I never seen him play anything else in tournament, really.
He might have had a couple weeks back, I saw him pluck Ganondorf. They made it work. They got a couple wins off of Jesus and Fabian. So, but yeah, no, definitely. The Ness villager is a scary combo. I'm guessing this is a button check because I've never seen Sam go into a game and not have a button check. Yeah, they're button checking.
Oh, yeah.
I've never seen Sam go into a game and not have a button check. So I'm actually wondering.
I'm wondering if SSB 100 is going to stay with this one. Yeah, if he's going to try and summon through. He hasn't switched to Rosalina. I mean, it is the button check. He could be just waiting until the game gets in.
That's
like, you know, it's like, why make the change until the button check? And so, we're going to pause, close it out.
That's what I was thinking, but he could stick with the Marth.
Yeah, I mean, at this situation, you know how the Rosalina Diddy Kong pairing went. You're in loser's side. I feel like you can take this first game, take a gamble, see how the Marth does, and that's what they're going to do.
Yeah, dude, this is definitely, I definitely think.
I like this adaptation.
Like, Rosalina, honestly, is good versus Ness and Villager, but I think the problem is they just never had something that could just, like, be their frontliner type thing with Diddy.
Yeah, I don't think SSB plays it to that style. I don't think it's how he wants to play in this 2v2, and now we're going to see how this works out for them. Immediately, they get red team into the corner. But, again, SSB taking his massive percent damage while Knight Money not taking a lot himself, but he's able to get some throws going.
But myself and Sinnerfish have both taken a good amount of percent as well.
Very true. Punch of interaction right there on the stage. A lot of damage, nobody dying yet, but Samfish edge guarding SSB so hard.
And that's
he got
his jump.
Stock. And Knight Money going to go down as well. God. This is looking commanding.
Yeah, that is the one thing about Marth is like he's
a gimp on to Knight Money. They are starting off this one strong.
That is one thing about Diddy Kong and Marth is you catch their drop or catch their upbeat, that can really hurt them. And honestly, Villager, I'd say, is one of the best at going and gimming.
Yeah, so now it's going to take a lot for SSB and Knight Money to run this back down.
Oh no! And
this should be over. Four stock lead, four blue team, nine of them getting into a killer zone. With the way everything's been going, it just does not look good.
Yeah.
They're just gonna call it.
Ooh. That's not a way you want to start grand finals.
Yeah. Still, I do have respect for SSB 100 sticking with the mark, seeing if that was gonna be good, but now that, after seeing that performance, now the Rosalina pick that we've seen from him makes a lot more sense. It's been way more competitive with it. He's been able to absorb a lot of projectiles, and that's one thing that Rosalina does very well. But we're not going to see that.
Ooh. I know he has a Khorne. I know he likes Khorne. This could be interesting.
So Khorne's recovery probably a little worse than Mars in a sense, just because of the range on the up B. However,
it does have a bigger hitbox.
And he is going to be a lot. He's going to cover a lot more ground because he is going to have the side B to play with. He's going to give him another option there, and he does have the neutral B, although with Villager on the team, he could just very well pocket it. But already, again, we see SSB taking a lot of damage.
And Sam is not taking much damage, and neither is myself. They are actually, they got a good about
60% total?
Yeah, 60% total, 30 per character. Playing pretty good. Oh no, but myself did not have a jump.
So he is going to SD, so a strong start actually for blue team.
Yeah.
And then SSB, actually, that upbeat recovery working fairly well as we try to edgeguard him. He is going to eat the Lloyd.
He's going to eat the Lloyd that was written by Sam.
Yep.
And the tree is up.
And still no kill. These guys are hanging in there. Force recover high, but great setup right now. There's so much suffocation right now. That tree denied a lot on him. And then SSB getting it.
Money just goes right into SSB's forward smash. That is unlucky right there.
Very much so. So they did have a strong start at first. Got the early kill of Miso, but now it's gone down and they are down a stock.
Yep. And Sam is just taking that stuff. And Sam is not just going to die really easily. He will keep away. And most setups are not going to work on a villager right now. He's way too
old. But Miso paying in kind with the team kill.
And I think Night Money either hit Sam's or threw him into Miso. So that's actually hilarious.
It's a good heads of play from Night, so. Night Money, excuse me. Night, so. Like, who's that?
I feel like Mizup is going for way too many PK Thunders right now. He's just like going from all the time.
Mm-hmm. Smash pressure. Night Money on the ledge.
This is scary.
Get back.
Right now, Ness has so. Like, an up air, a back air, a back throw can really do a lot. Oh, there's that back
throw. There's that back throw.
That's going to kill. That's going to kill.
That's going to kill, and then. SSB still staying alive. Looks like there wasn't a whole lot of understanding what was going on there. He is going to get fish those down airs.
And there's another
like
back throw.
There's another back throw, yeah. So now two stocks to four total, excuse me.
Two to four, yeah.
So two stock deficit for blue team. But, both? I mean, all they have to do is get, like, the right hits. That is not the right hit, SSB.
Yeah, that is not the right hit. Yeah, I think, I don't know, they just, SSB and Nightmare just keep hitting each other right now. Mm-hmm.
They don't seem to be comfortable with the corn.
Yeah, I know.
Corn does. She does have huge hitboxes, or he in this case. But that can come back to bite you just if your team is down too close. Nice little monkey flip. Trying to set it up for SSB to follow up, but Sandfish going to come to the rescue of the net. And they are going to get the gimp. He is going to go down. Corn trying to recover, but it is going to be
and it. Himself with the smart recovery. Up B, hit the wall, and instantly up B again. So that is a quick 2-0. This is game three.
So the corn pick didn't work out.
And the Marth pick didn't work out.
So what does... Who pivots here? Is Night Money going to be the one pivot? Is SSB going to try to do another character change? Back to the Rosaline and the Luma. They have won a game with him. They're just going to run right back to Final Destination.
Yeah, I guess so. This is interesting. The biggest problem with this is they don't really have a front line because Diddy Kong doesn't really want to just be fighting multiple people. And Rosaline is definitely not one because Rosaline is incredibly light and...
Yeah, but so far the percent trade is actually in favor.
Yeah, no.
More blue team.
Yeah, Night Money's getting a lot of control on himself. Even though SSB is taking a lot of percent, so is Sandfish and himself.
Yeah, and Night Money is not going up. This is working out pretty well for him. This lets Night Money just be very safe right now, but that is going to be a kill.
With really like that Ness up air will kill at that percent.
Yeah, so now they're going to split things up, try and get everything in there. Try to set up Sandfish for SSB's up smash.
Oh,
he does get the gimp. That's the one thing. But he is going to go down himself. Unfortunate, but that's what SSB has been really good at with the Rosaline pick, and what's really been a strength of them is that if they get Miso off the edge, he's able to go down and absorb the PK Thunder.
But the thing is, you can't just keep your life for it every time. You have
So yeah, I mean it's a trade that's gonna definitely work in favor of red team, so we're gonna try and get Sandfish down. Not gonna work so well. Luma is currently dead.
No.
Quick kill on the Sandfish though. So all things considered, they are tied in stocks, but
and the percentages.
There goes that stock for them. So now
I actually have no idea what happened there.
I lost track of Night Self as well.
And there goes the tree.
There goes the tree. Nice up there, but I mean, again, right now looking at Miso, he's a lot of shield pressure, but he's at 91%. That up smash not gonna finish him. Yeah. Luma is currently down.
I feel like Miso is getting away with a lot of those PK Thunder too, just in the middle of the stage. I feel like I don't know how he's just doing them and not getting punished at all, but I don't know. Yeah, if they can hit, there we go. Ooh,
not yet. Good DI for Miso. He's gonna get thrown off stage. And SSB immediately gonna turn on to Sam. I expected him to. Oof, goes for an up forward smash. Not gonna get it.
Oh, no.
And then the team gets.
Oh my god.
Immediately now, down to last stock. This is very much looking like myself and Sam pitch this game. I don't know what's going to have to happen. Very interesting interaction. There is going to be the up smash.
Yeah, that does. I will take a stock. If they can get Sam for this time, they can actually tie up the stocks. But I don't know. This game is.
Yeah, it's looking. It looks very difficult. They're going to have to get a gimp, I think. Onto myself. Using SSB's Rosalina and have him not SD.
Yeah,
I feel like that's the window. Or maybe get the hit. They both have a Magic Guarded right now.
Nah, Misel's been very good at not letting himself get to that point after that original one.
Oh, SSB eating the PK Thunder so that it doesn't connect with Ness. For more damage and more shield pressure. Lands in between them. Really separated. Isn't a throw. Samfish off stage. Misel doing the same thing. Everyone gonna get back safely. It's very tense right now, but the longer it takes.
Oh no, that back throw. Oh no.
Gonna seal it right now. Now he has to be forced in the 2v1.
He's at 100%.
Down 3 stocks and 100%. And the tree gonna seal the deal. It's a clean 3-0 for myself with Sam Fish.
3-0. And honestly, that was the closest game, and that I still didn't feel like that was
that close.
Yeah.
Very much advantage. I feel like just the character choices are really limiting Night Money and SSB in terms of options.
I feel like also with Night Money and SSB, they just kept hitting each other so many times with big smash attacks and almost killing each other or killing each other. So it was just like, I feel like when they're facing Big Red and Avian, they have a lot more synergy, but versus Sam and myself, they just...
Well, I feel like it all had a lot to do with the character. Like, when we saw when SSB was allowed to play as Marth, front line for the Diddy Kong, you know, you have two people who can go in for those kill options with an effective front line.
Yeah.
But then, when you have Villager and Ness, there's so much projectiles coming up. Marth can't approach.
Yeah, I know, it's very...
Hey, guys, last games.
So that is going to be the last games, and we're probably going to be shutting the stream down soon. I just want to thank you guys for hanging out with us at Smash at Colorado School of Mines 41 for the doubles set. Congratulations to Sam Fish, a lucky man today. He won both the singles bracket and the doubles bracket, so he's walking away with a dank, like, what, $20?
Yeah, it was a smaller showing today, but I don't know. Still a lot of fun. We still got some top names and PR, but...
Very true. Anyways, we just want to thank you guys for tuning in to the stream. This is CD Mangaka.
This is Greg Asylum.
Signing off.
Yeah.